He's gonna be okay. Nobody would harm a child. It'll be okay, I promise. It'll be okay. Someone needs to be okay.
You're boring me now.
Oh, hi, Arthur.
Miss O'Shea?
Oh, look, Sip. Good to meet you.
under.
Fish you fools is about to eat.
Hey, boy.
I thanked you already.
Come here. Not loud
enough. Arthur! Oh, Arthur!
You smell. It's cologne. It's liquor. It's cologne from Cologne, Germany. Oh, I just had a few nips, Arthur. I'm not drunk. I'm just happy. You know, you ought to try sometime.
Drinking?
Happiness. Try happiness. Just a little.
Sir, the watch is picked from a fob's
Bill.
Hi, Arthur.
Jose.
Hello, Mary Beth.
Oh, how are you, Arthur?
Fine. How are you?
I'm well, I think. It's been quite a run we've had, but we're still alive.
Mm. So, no regrets?
Regrets for what?
Well, for joining this band of maniacs.
If you're a girl without means in this world, life is very scary. You boys care for me before no one cared for me. Well, life weren't very nice, Arthur. Not after Mama got typhoid, and that was a long time ago.
Sure.
What about you? I heard you ran into that Mary girl.
Yep.
And?
Got me thinking how that all ended. Long time ago now.
What happened?
Well, she didn't love me enough, I guess. Or I wouldn't change.
Huh. Well, she was a fool then, Arthur.
Well, she put a lot of good years in on an outlaw. She definitely was a fool.
In these books, life seems so simple, but in reality, I can't make head nor tail of it.
Mr. Morgan! Mr. Morgan, we have a problem. A real problem. It's Tilly.
What?
She's been taken by them Foreman brothers she used to run with. Come along!
The Foreman brothers? What are they doing here?
Well, I don't know what they've been doing here, but I can tell you what they're going to be doing here. Dying.
Sure. Do we need more guns?
You and I can handle this, Arthur.
Where are we heading?
I'll tell you on the way. Just get going. Yeah. All right, head for Rhodes. And quick!
She's in Rhodes?
No. She's at a place called Bradley's house, just west of there.
How do you know?
When we first got here, she told me she was worried that our camp was near a safe house that gang she ran with used from time to time.
And you told Dutch?
No. She spoke to me in confidence. I suppose I didn't think it would be a problem.
And now it is.
Oh, yes.
What do they want with her anyway? I think I saw one of the foremen hassling her and Valentine.
Yes, they probably followed us down here. You don't know what happened? She killed one of them, for good reason, but clearly they don't see it that way.
Tilly?
Yes. Young Tilly Jackson isn't as sweet and innocent as you might think. But like I say, she was defending herself. She fled and fell in with us right after that. I just hope we can get to her in time.
It's not too far.
If they've touched a single hair on that girl's head, I will eviscerate the sons of bitches.
See? You do care, Miss Grimshaw.
Of course I care. About all of you fools. Some just require a firmer hand than others. You especially.
Well, thank you.
I swear, half of you would just rot in your own filth if nobody kept you in check.
No doubt.
Well, I don't know. First Jack, now Tilly? This isn't good, Arthur.
Listen, kidnappings ain't nothing new. These things happen sometimes. Hell, they've happened to you.
I know. Never gets any easier, though.
We'll get them both back. Some help. Oh, get out of here.
Oh, I see that kindly face of yours, and I know that for the right inducement, a gentleman such as yourself could be mighty kind.
Now get out of here.
Oh, now you keep saying that, but you don't mean nothing by
it. I said
you said your last words. Well, what are you waiting for? Get in there and find our girl. Go find her before they put a bullet in her head.
Arthur! What the hell you think you're doing?
It's okay, Miss Tilly. Now, let's get you out of here.
I thought there was...
Yeah, it don't matter what you thought. It's okay. All right, let's go.
Oh, come along, miss. Thank you, both of you.
What happened?
It was Anthony Foreman. He thinks he owns me.
I remember. Where is he?
He went out hunting or something. There were five of them, I think.
Well, we killed those fellas there.
There they are.
Come on.
Tilly, grab that gun. Anyone approaches, shoot him!
Oh, don't worry, I'll be just fine. Now catch that bastard.
The one in front of the vault, bring him back alive. I ain't
done. All right, get after them. There, straight ahead. I saw him go through those bushes. You've got a couple more seconds to regret what you did. Come on, we've got him now. You've got him. They're heading down the hill to the water. Oh, there they are by the shoreline.
Are you out of your mind, lady?
We're coming for you, you bastards. All right, I think that last one's the boss. Lasso him and we'll take him back to Tilly. I want Tilly to have the last word on this bastard.
Oh!
Use the lasso. Don't kill him yet.
Stay away from me. I'm warning you.
All right. I think that last one's the boss. Lasso him and we'll take him back to Tilly. Don't let him get away! Don't kill him yet. I want Tilly to have the last word on this bastard.
You're making a big mistake. Tilly, Jackson ain't yours to have.
Go on! Rope that bastard!
I promise you don't want a war with me.
Come here.
That's it. Now make sure you tie him up real good.
Get this off of me.
Make these nice and tight.
All right. You bring that bastard back to Tilly so we can all have a nice little chat. I'm gonna head over there now to check she's okay.
With pleasure.
I'll take your horse.
Do you have the first idea what you're getting into? I'm Anthony Foreman.
Well, thanks for the introduction, Anthony. Is that Foreman with an A? I want the Undertaker to spell it right.
Funny bastard. Who are you running with?
She didn't...
Get off me!
She didn't tell you?
She didn't tell me nothing. This rope is cutting into me.
Don't feel so good when you're the one tied up, does it?
She killed my goddamn cousin.
Oh, shit. Oh, don't worry. You'll be seeing him soon enough.
What are you gonna do with me?
I ain't sure yet. Reckon I'll let Tilly decide what you deserve.
You're wasting your time with that girl. She's a liar. She'll screw you over like she did me. I should have shot the bitch yesterday like I said I would.
You just shut your mouth now, Anthony. I've heard enough.
son of a damn coward. All right, damn it.
Here's your man.
Bring him here. Dump him on the ground here. I want to get a good look at this monster. Are you getting him off the horse, then?
So he's still alive, then?
Yes.
You see this girl? You leave her alone.
She killed my cousin.
Your goddamn cousin had it coming, Anthony Foreman.
I don't care if she shot your daddy and cooked your mama for breakfast. She's mine. She ain't yours.
You know, a friend of mine, he always says, revenge is a fool's game. Now, you want all your boys dead? She had her reasons.
We was family, Tilly Jackson.
You Foreman boys ain't no kind of family I want.
Kill him, Arthur!
You want that?
I want him to go away and tell the remaining of his cousins and the clowns he rides with to leave me alone!
Now, you think you can do that, Anthony? Or should I slit your throat and just save us all the bother?
I'll leave you alone. History is done.
History is never done. It's your call, Arthur. But I'd slit his throat.
Go on.
All right, you.
Come on. Let's get you home.
Now get out of here.
Thank you. Can't smell that good.
There you are.
You boys ready?
Of course. What else do you know about this guy?
Not much. Just these some slick little greasy-haired Europeans. Clearly got power and money. Now, listen. If we go in there and start shooting up the place, boy's gonna get shot, that I guarantee. Better like this, you're gonna have a lot of protection.
Ain't no one gonna get shot, Arthur, so everyone just relax. We'll charm them. Trust me. This the place?
Must be.
You okay, John? I guess.
Excuse me, sir. We have an appointment to see Mr. Bronte.
Who are you?
You get your boss down here and now so we can talk about this like gentlemen. Run along now, boy.
Was that the special Dutch charm I heard so much about?
Relax. You looking for a problem? I got this.
Don't worry, boys. We come in peace.
We just need to straighten a couple of things out with your boss.
Sono sti buffoni.
Sono qui per picciotto.
Coi soldi?
Why do you take his son?
Excuse me.
I said, why did you take his son? We ain't got no problems with you, sir. Nor you with us. But if you want to start one, there's gonna be a lot of folks dead in this room before it's done.
So, you walk into my city, stinking of shit and looking like this, and you come into my house before you have a bath and you tell me how to act? You ask me to show compassion. Have I not shown you almost infinite compassion already by simply allowing you to breathe in my presence?
Indeed you have. Now, we are simple country folk. All we have is each other. And you have gone and you have took his son over some dispute with some inbred ex-slavers. It ain't got nothing to do with any one of us.
You had nothing to do with destroying the liquor business!
We was innocent bystanders. And that which we weren't innocent of, well, we most surely were ignorant of.
You twist words, you lie shamelessly. You think you are better than everyone else. Ti adoro. Date da beresti uomini. Angelo Bronte.
Dutch Vanderlyn. Arthur Morgan.
Arthur, the pleasure is mine.
John Marston.
All mine, please.
So, can my friend have his son?
Of course, of course. But should I be out of pocket over a misunderstanding? Of course I know you would not want that, huh?
No.
So how about this? You perform a simple job for me, and you get your son back.
What is it?
A couple of people have taken to grave robbing in this cemetery.
Well, that is a fine place for it, the best.
I love this guy. I love you. See, they've taken not only to desecrating the dead, but they've done so without paying a tribute to the living. Thing is, they see my men, of course they run a mile. So maybe you two head off, huh? And you, Mr. van der Linde, well, you tell me more about my manners. Salute.
Salute.
Okay, then, girl.
Grave robbers? You think he's taking us for a fool?
No idea. What choice do we have?
None, I guess. This is idiotic.
You know where the cemetery is?
I think so. Pretty sure I rode by it earlier. It's real impressive.
You know, you did good holding your tongue in there.
Do you trust one word that comes out of that bastard's mouth? We don't even know where Jack is.
Listen, we found Bronte. We got in there. Dutch is with him now. All things considered, it could have gone a lot worse.
That poor kid. I ain't been a good father to him. I hope he's okay.
He'll be fine. I figure the Braithwaites were going to hold Jack ransom for all the money we cost him. Must have sent him here so we couldn't get to him. But Bronte knows by now there's no Braithwaites left to pay him. Jack ain't much use to him anymore. Let's just get this done. Let Dutch handle the rest.
I just hope you're right.
You trying to start something?
What's wrong with you?
Okay. I think this is it. Keep it down. Let's hitch your horses up ahead.
Watch out! Can't you control that damn horse?
You rest up.
This way. Come on. Find him and get the hell out of here. How are we gonna get Jack back now? This way. Quiet.
boy. Well, they can't be far. Let's keep going.
I can't believe we're doing this.
I know, but you won't care once we get the boy back.
That bastard better keep his word.
I'm gonna push your head. You wash my back.
Waking up, or somebody's trying to wake him.
Okay. Come on. Hey, John, over here. Get in cover, and we'll bust the door in.
You boys found my puppies, watch it!
How many you see?
Three? Four? Hard to tell.
You should have paid Mr. Bronte.
I'm hit!
Okay, but we'll need to be quick.
We can't go back to Bronte empty-handed. Let's have a look where they first shot at us from.
Robbing grave robbers. We've hit the big time.
Like I said, let's look around where they jumped us. We can't go back to Bronte with nothing to show for it, Arthur. Let's quickly check that spot where it all kicked off.
Think there might be something in here. Got it.
Good. Now let's get out of here. Damn, the law's here. Come on, let's see if that gate's open. It's locked. We'll have to go back the way we came.
Damn it! Come on.
Let's go around the side. Get down!
Straight.
Shit. That's all we need. We gotta lose them, Morgan.
Push me.
I'll kill you.
Come on.
Damn, the law's here! Come on, let's see if that gate's open! Locked. Let's just track back to where we came in.
Damn it!
Come on. Let's go around the side.
I'm gonna feel the full of all you son of a bitch.
think we lost him.
Almost had a bad day right there. Can we just go now?
Come on, quick! Let's get back to Dutch.
Well, it's lucky I ain't a religious man.
Let's just get back there, collect our side of the deal.
You all right?
He best not be playing games with us.
He almost certainly is. Let's just see. Keep your head. Act normal.
How's he even gonna know we did what he asked?
Things around here get back to him pretty fast. Like I said, you see where we're at once we got Jack.
Get this done.
Well, you took your time.
Where's your host?
Like I said, you took your time.
Am I glad to see you.
Let's get going. What a fine man. Hey, friend. Thank Mr. Bronte for everything.
Yeah, I'm fine.
Come on.
You know, Arthur, Mr. Bronte has invited us to a garden party at the mayor's house. And us, just simple country boys. There. Let's go! We have a new camp set up, Jack. You're gonna love it.
Yep.
Move it, come on!
All right, let's get this boy back to his mother.
You sure you're okay, son?
I'm fine. Papa Bronte said you'd come for me.
I'm sorry.
What for?
For that. For taking so long.
I had a fun time. I had my own room with a big bed and a toy box. And lots of books.
Did they do anything to you?
Have you ever had spaghetti?
What? What's that?
It's food. It looks like worms, but it's delicious.
Is that right?
Papa Bronte teaches me lots of Italian words.
Don't call him that, please.
You know, cavallo? That means horse. And pantofola? That's a slipper.
A slipper?
They gave me two pairs. One for day and one for night.
Well, I'm just glad you're all right.
Oh, yes. I had the best time. But I can't wait to see Mama. Did she miss me?
She sure did. Like...
Abigail! Abigail! We got you, your son, everything!
We got him!
Mama!
He's fine!
I'm fine, Mama. They fed me good. Italian food. You ever eat that?
Come here, you silly boy. You got him. You got my son back. Dutch, Arthur, thank you. Thank you. I got my son back!
Jack! How are you, boy?
I'm fine, thanks.
Everything's okay now. Abigail?
Can I go play now?
So?
Well, we met Mr. Bronte. He is quite a character.
Is he now?
You ever meet an Italian strong man before?
Not outside of a circus.
Well, let me tell you all about him. John, you go be with your family. Arthur, thank you. Boys, we got some work to do. Interesting work. But first, let's have a drink. We got Jack back!
Well, the boy's safe, thank goodness.
Thank you, Arthur. I don't know how to say it. Thank you.
I understand. Come on. Do as Dutch says. Go be with your family.
Make some room for John there.
Come on, are we celebrating?
Yes, sir. Oh, good to have you back, kid. We missed you. Hey, how about a song, huh?
How are you?
Out of the air. Play us away.
De la Sierra Morena, cielito lindo, vienen bajando. Un par de ojitos negros, cielito lindo de contrabando. De la Sierra Morena, cielito lindo, vienen bajando. Un par de ojitos negros, cielito lindo de contrabando.
Ay, 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 ay. Cantan los flores,
porque cantando se alegra. Ese lunar que tiene cielito lindo junto a la boca, no se lo des a nadie, cielito lindo que a mí me toca. Ese lunar que tiene cielito lindo junto a la boca, no se lo des a nadie, cielito lindo que a mí me toca.
Ay, 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 ay.
Cantando se alegran, cielito lindo, los corazones.
Ay, 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 ay.
Canta y no llores, porque cantando se alegran, cielito lindo, los corazones.
Boy, a bit of space.
See you later.
Good to have you back, Jackie.
We miss you.
Welcome back, Jack.
Thanks.
You must be starving, son. Let me get you something to eat.
Thanks, Mama. Can I play a little?
Of course you can. Well done, John.
Couldn't have done it without Dutch and Arthur.
The old guard. I'm very relieved. We all are.
Yeah. Thank God.
Welcome back, Jack.
Thanks, Jack.
Well,
I'll let you find folks. Onde habitan los pichones?
Hey, Mary Beth.
Miss Gaskill!